Good day, huh? Welcome to the stream, everybody. 292 days into making Songbringer. Today I'm working on... I'm going to do a playthrough, actually. First, I'm actually going to finish this new thing. I got Twilight. Twilight! Special Twilight colors. So I just got to tweak this a little bit. So I'm going to be in this area right here. I've been tweaking colors all day, working on the levels, the color burn, the soft light, and all that. And now I've got a new little effect that will happen only at twilight, only for a very short period of the day. We'll have this really glowing look. Yeah, twilight. So let me send this tweet. There we go. Okay. All right, so got it all hooked up into the shader so that I can apply twilight. But I just want it to only apply for a certain part of the day. So twilight amount is going to be something totally different than this calculation. Not totally different, but it's twilight is going to be a mix, not 4F, but right? Yeah, that picture. Yeah, I think we both follow him. Yeah, he's funny. So I want to mix F. Yeah, I want to mix F between 0 So based on your outdoorness. No, what up? Nope. Actually, this is a 4F. Damn. All right. This is simple. All right. So based on the outdoorness and your lightness, outdoor or indoors, it's completely 0. There's never any twilight indoors, but outdoors, it ranges from one amount to another, but this is based on, what's up, Jonah19? This is going to be based on how close it is to sunset. So sunset is... Here, let's get a sunset amount. What's that going to be? That's if lightness is right around 0.5. Yeah, playthrough time, playthrough. I'm just finishing up the twilight first. This is going to be a simple thing. Let people get on the stream and stuff too. So yeah, oh, it's lightness minus 0.5. That gives us the how close it is. Actually, if that's abs, that's how close it is to sunset. And then just multiply that down by anywhere from a quarter to an eighth or something like that, and then divide it by. Let's do a float, const float, sunset window. So that's the amount of the day between 0 and 1 that it's going to be sunset. And I'm thinking that's going to be like an eighth of the day. Maybe a quarter. Let's start with a quarter of the day. An eighth. Yeah. So it's going to be lightness minus a 0.5. That would become... right by sunset, it would be 0, because that's going to be 1.0 minus, or 0.5 minus the lightness. This gives us the sunset amount. Right, so we have 0.5 minus... So if lightness is 1.0, we have 1.0 minus a half is a half, times a half, that's a quarter. Or, no, wait. If lightness is 1.0, this becomes 0.5, and this becomes sunset amount 0. Right, so that would be full lightness, would be 0 sunset. And if we're at full darkness, or 0 lightness, that would be negative a half. abs, which become a half, 0.5 minus that. So this becomes 0.5. This ranges from 0 to 0.5. I guess we can multiply it by 2. Now we have a proper 0 to 1. Okay, and then multiplying that by the sunset window. So the sunset amount No, that's not right. Sunset amount equals clamp F01. Sunset amount. What's up, Boogie? I'm about to do a playthrough, but right now I'm working on Twilight. So I just got a new effect that does Twilight. And I'm just gonna throw this in here. So right when it gets close to sunset, it'll do Twilight. Really? Your internet again? And what's up with that? Okay. So sunset amount. We've got a factor right now from 0 to 1. How close it is to sunset. Now I just want to amplify that. Or no, subtract it basically. So if the sunset window is only a quarter per the day, like the vampire thing? No. Yeah, totally. I saw your tweet today, Lime Studios. Yeah, it looks awesome, man. That's so exciting. You got dual monitors and everything. So if we have a sunset amount of 1.0, that's going to become like a sunset window of 0.125. So that's times sunset window. Right, sunset amount. So yeah, and then, but no, I want to chop it off. Like, so below, well, sweet, you got it all hooked up. Everything you need. So 1.0. Basically, if the sunset amount is anything less than 0.875, it becomes 0. Otherwise, it gets amped up. So that's going to be... Oh, yeah. Did you apply for it? Did you apply for your developer PS4? And do you have something to show, like your company? Do you have your game to show them and all that? What's up, Cedric? Welcome to stream, man. I'm working on Twilight. I'm just trying to take this sunset amount. I'm trying to make it so there's only twilight applied during a very small window. Nice. You're in the process? Good, man. Ah, okay. What's up, Arcane? Yeah, so we take the sunset amount, subtract the 1.0 minus the sunset window. And then multiply that by 1.0 or divide it by the sunset window. So if we have a sunset amount of 1.0, sunset amount's 1.0. Sunset window is 0.125. That's gonna be 1 minus 0.875, which would become 0.125. And then dividing that by the sunset window would become 1.0 once again. If we have a value of, say, 0.9, which is really close to the edge where it could possibly be, 0.9. Minus 0.875 is 0.025, and then dividing that by the sunset window, 0.125, so that would become like 0.2, right? So, and then if it became anything less, like if we had a sunset amount of 0.8, we subtract out 0.875, we're going to get a negative number, dividing that by the sunset window. Clamping that, it's all good. Okay, so that's our sunset amount. I can step through this and make sure that is right. And then twilight amount at... Oh, twilight amount is just sunset amount. Okay, yeah, so this is... We don't need this whole complicated mix 4F anymore. We just need to mix it based on mix is going to become between outdoorness. Okay, out, so it's gonna be 0.0 to sunset amount based on outdoorness. So at fully outdoors, we have a full sunset. And fully indoors, we have no sunset. Yeah, I'm doing good, man. I'm so excited. I'm starting to get my health really good, too. Like, my body's feeling really good. This summer, my body was just in crazy shape. I had been eating way too many eggs and peanut butter and all this crazy crap that, like, just messed me up, basically. Okay, that was way quick. Let's see that a little slower. I might have had that like backwards somewhere too. I know eggs are so good, right? You fixed a bug? Oh, right on. Sweet buffo. Yeah, the cholesterol, the saturated fats. Really what it was, I've been reading this book on health and everything. And it's basically, it did a lot of things to my body. Like, basically it stagnated my liver, which also hurt my kidneys, and then it started hurting my heart. So there's a lot to, you know, when you eat a certain way for a long, long time, it can really fuck you up bad. Basically, that's the takeaway lesson there. All right, so we got game. Let's slow that down. See that? What happened to this? That is. Oh, let's get hour. Okay, so I want this to be, let's do 20 seconds instead of 10. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, totally. I'm starting to have energy again, you know, like the energy I'm used to. I'm like super bouncy and it's awesome. All right, let's start the day a little, we're at time 250. Let's go more like time zero. Oh, this has nothing to do with time. Never mind. Static double start. Constable window. There we go. You just forgot to call the method. That was it. Oh, that's totally not even a bug. Nope. Okay, that was too close to the time window. It's like comes on too fast. And it goes away too fast. But I'm still wondering if it needs to be inverted. I definitely need to tweak the effect and everything, but I want to get to the playthrough here. Huh. So if there's a bigger window for the sunset, and I think I want it to start maybe closer to the sunset. Okay. Yeah. Oh, it was. It's definitely doing it right for its factors. But I think the sunset, let's see, maybe if lightness is like, let's put it closer to 0.25. So if lightness is 0.25, that's going to become 0. That's going to be 0.5 minus 0 times 2. So if lightness is 0, that's going to become 0.25, which is going to be a quarter away from the sunset amount. If lightness is 1.0, that's going to be 0.75, which would become negative 0.25. Yeah, okay, that'll still work. But it'd be nice if this were clamp F right here before we did. Did that. So there. Thanks, Cedric. Appreciate that, man. Really. Yeah. I really appreciate that. When I started this whole game a year ago, like, I had no art skills. Like, really, I just barely any art skills, and it's just through the daily practice of making it better and better and better, There. Oh, now that sunset was right, just at about the right time. That looked pretty good. Yeah, so it's just been a daily iterative kind of art skill improvement. There, that was sweet. That was like a nice golden glow, right at just the right time. Maybe even a smaller window now, actually. Let's try a window. Oh, let's do a const float. Sunset. Center sunset time, I guess. 0.25. Thanks, man. Yeah, I appreciate it. Yeah, repetition. Yeah, now this fade's starting to look good. And it'll look even better in the game at the actual game's time. You know, this is like way sped up. Yeah, that was good. But yeah, I think it should be a little bit wider of a window. So more like, instead of point, let's do 0.1618. And let's see it sped. Well, no, let's do it one more time, seeing it at that speed. All right, so I'm almost ready to do this playthrough. I got my controller all hooked up. I think I'm going to do a total reset of the game. That was a nice blend. Ha, I like this. I like this a lot. Maybe that should be a little bit closer here, though. More like 0.3310 or something. All the way through the whole game? I think that would take like 6 hours or so. So, let's see. Let's see this window shorter. You can see this a little faster. Yeah, the shadows, I really improved those today too. So what I've been doing all morning, I've been working on the levels, the color burning, the soft light, the shadows, the length of the shadows, the depth of the shadows, the opacity of the shadows, everything. It's really been tweaking it. I've been taking tons of screenshots and just looking at it and going, no, a little bit more levels, a little bit less levels, a little bit more max levels, a little bit more min levels, whatever. You know, and then looking at it outdoors, indoors, different areas. So basically the whole day I've been working on the colors and the brightnesses and levels and all that. What's up, Stadoff? Can you make this game with JavaScript or it'll be hard? Oh no, definitely not going to make it with JavaScript. I could have made this game with JavaScript, yes. But I decided not to right at the very beginning and definitely would not switch it now. I mean, now I'm 45,000 lines deep in this game. Rewriting all that with JavaScript would be hell. So definitely would not change it at this point. And I definitely would not change my decision to not write it with JavaScript. I think I like JavaScript in some ways, but it's really, it can be kind of buggy the way their CocoStudioX is, it's basically Google's Spider Monkey. It can kind of sometimes be unreliable. Like when I was using CocoStudioJS and all that, it was a lot of times it would crash, and I wouldn't have no clue why. What's up, Thomas? I'm not talking about the HTML5 version. I'm talking about JavaScript running in actual native. Like CocoStudioX has JavaScript binding, so you can actually write your whole game in JavaScript. But it still can compile for native. Like you can actually Windows, Mac, Linux. So you're writing your whole game in JavaScript, still publishing on Windows, Mac, Linux, and you can also publish the same game to HTML5 with some tweaks a little bit. Oh yeah. Oh no, I was just, I know you weren't requesting. I'm just telling you the realities of JavaScript development for native. Okay, I'm happy with that. That's looking pretty good. We'll check that in. Let's go back to regular game time. Right, let's see it one more time. I wasn't paying attention there for a second. Yeah, I know. Why would you do that? The reason you would do that is because is mainly because you can publish to either platform. You can publish to HTML5 or native. That's really the only reason that I think is a good one. JavaScript might be easier for some people, but JavaScript is kind of tricky. It's really tricky to develop with. It's hard to set breakpoints in JavaScript, you know? It's like it can be really time consuming to try and develop your game in JavaScript because it's just so, it's not very debugger friendly, you know? What's up, everybody? Schoenberger, Dumplings, Knock, Cover, the Space Mon. Yeah, I'm like, that was good. So putting that at 0.3 was pretty good there. So this is gonna be regular game time now. Yeah, it is a totally different beast. Boogie. All right, sweet. We're back to regular game time. You can see the shadow of the girl here moving slowly. This is about how fast the game does its normal day-night cycle. Which seems kind of fast, but it is a whole 10 minutes. What's up, Cuddlebeam? How you doing? All right, so I'm gonna check that in. And we're ready to do playthrough. Minecraft is 20 minutes? Really? I did not know that. What's up, Salad Dongs? All right, so I'm gonna save my saves file. And I'm going to delete my whole saves file and start from the very beginning. I guess I will. I'm going to totally start totally over. So this playthrough will be fresh. All right. Let's do this. Playing the game now. Start thinking about what world seed you want to see. That's for anybody that's new to this stream, you're wondering what the heck this is and everything. This game's called Songbringer, and you enter a six-letter world seed at the very beginning. So whoever gives me the very first six-letter world seed on the chat, I'll do that world seed. Fresh! All right, Jonah, fresh it is. Oh no, your Animal Crossing game? Nice, I'm glad it's going well, Cuddlebeam. Yes, Woogie, get a git before, yeah, you need a git. Definitely get a git now, man. We got fresh with two H's or fresh with two S's. That's gonna be a totally different world. Oh no, it doesn't allow me to use my... From the first bug already. So it didn't allow me to input any key at the very beginning there. PS4, PS3 next time. So I gotta take notes. I do this every time I'm doing a playthrough. I take notes on, hold on, that is using so much of my CPU. Set that back. Set that to 30. With no bindings, it doesn't allow any key to start menu. And controller doesn't bind. Okay. First note written down. You switch from Git to Mercurial because it's easier to have large files. Oh, nice. Yeah, Git has that, but you got to enter in some like special, a few special settings to make sure your Git is right. I know the fan was going crazy. That's what the game sounds like when I'm running, when I got live streaming going on in the background, which eats tons of CPU and GPU, and then trying to run the game at 60 frames a second too on a laptop. So this is running the game at 30 frames a second. It should be quiet. It's gonna blow. You hate setting up repos, right? Oh damn, I forgot. Okay, so I gotta manually bind some keys. Wow, that was not easy. Alright. Yeah, source tree is great. You got a GTX 960? Oh no! Do you already have an Oculus? Hey, what's up, Sam's number one fan? Yo! Butter. Oh, you wanted butter for the seed? We're already doing fresh. But butter's a cool one. Dude, butter would be sweet. Alright, permadeath or regular though? Huh? Huh? Sebastian, what's up? Muddy. Permadeath? Regular? Permadeath, I guess it's gonna be permadeath if nobody speaks up. Thanks, backer. Andrew Stewart. Regular, huh? All right. Regular for testing, all right. We got two votes for regular. One and a half votes for permadeath. What's up, why not win? Okay, I'll go with regular, because probably... Yeah, that's what happened last time, huh? I did permadeath mode and I've... Okay, we'll do regular. Fresh. There's two S's, right? Or was it two? Was it two H's? Two S's. Two H's! Jonah's first original suggestion. From... Jonah's original suggestion, not first. All right, here we're doing this. We're doing this. I'm definitely not pro enough. So I read an article today about Oculus versus the Vive or the Vive or or whatever the how the hell you say that. And they're definitely saying that the, I don't know, the Vive or whatever is kind of heavy. So it sounds like the Oculus is still the one to get right now. All right, I'm liking these deeper shadows and brighter colors. This is nice. There's some good improvements made today. Oh no. The Sony VR? What's the Sony one? What's that one called? Nothing, man. Nothing in these grasses. Yeah, the HoloLens. Smoke animation bug? Where? Here? What's the bug? Help me see what you see. Oh, on the crash bug, you're right! Thank you, oh my god. What happened to the smoke? Ah, thank you guys, man. Good eye, Jonah. Crash bike, somehow the smoke didn't work. Should be an easy fix. PlayStation VR, a mid-range alternative, huh? Huh. Whoa, it looks crazy. Yeah, it's definitely solid smoke. That's an easy fix. Alright, just exploring around, making sure these walls and everything is all good. I love this is smoother now. Whoa, enemies here. Whoa. Enemies and no weapons. Alright, good. This one's blocked off too. This is only in regular mode that it blocks you off like this. In permadeath mode, it keeps it totally open. Oh wow, look at this. It locked me into this. Whoa, this shouldn't be like that. Finally found a bug with that. Alright, so we're talking, what is this? Fresh 800 has gate to the west. Alright, that should be an easy fix too. Smoke bikes every day. Oh, right, cave entrances? Yeah. Yeah, make them less flat, totally. Yeah, good call, Sams. I'll do that. So the cave entrance is less flat looking. Done. It's on the list. Yeah, right. Yeah, I haven't got the VR craze yet, but I'm sure at some point I will. Sweet, the shadows are looking a lot better. Look how sweet that looks with that awesome almost symmetry. Make them glow? Maybe. Alright, we got the sword. See, Thomas, you reached level 1 screen overworld with boss encounter, you remember? Yeah. If you were able to get down to level 1 and leave the boss, getting not to the... Oh, you have to beat him to get down. Yeah, Thomas, I did check that. Yeah, I remember that. And I fixed the bug from after that world. Remember, after that world, the boss reappeared? So, that's all fixed too. So, good question there. Hello, Filuto. Yes, these shadows are cool. This is a sweet improvement this morning. something else. The jitter is totally accidental. Supposed to jitter like one pixel or so when the enemy dies. It's supposed to go brrr, like that, and that time it didn't jitter as well, so I realized how accidental it was. All right, we're doing this. We're playing Seed Fresh with two H's on the end with nighttime already. It's because I've been dilly dallying like crazy. All right, which way should I go? Up, left? It's like full night right now. But the nighttime is a tiny bit brighter now for the player. For the rest, it's actually a tiny bit brighter too. The levels have been like really dialed in for the colors. Thanks, Filuto. The boss should come out from the statue. That's a cool idea. I've been meaning to put him in a different place when he starts. Sam's number one fan. All the shadows are just 2D sprites, totally GL. Or not GL, but they're totally C++, not GL. They are a little bit of combo with GL because there is a special shader. If anybody has any ideas on where I should go, let me know. Oh yeah, we got the boss, the mini boss. This is a cool place to fight the mini boss here. We got music this time to play the mini boss too. That's cool. Don't hurt Jib. Yay! Got the top hat. What's up here? It's really hard to explore at night because you don't know. It's hard to see all the paths. Go as far as northwest as you can. Well, we got left and northwest. Azenriz, what's up, man? Well, I think I'm already headed kind of in a northwesterly direction, so I guess I'll stay that way. Jib's way up there. Alright, it's starting to become morning now. You can see the twilight effect a little bit now. It's like a tiny bit orange. And it'll get more orange as the day comes on. How long have we been playing? 8 minutes? Ooh, is this a dead end? It is. Hi, Jib! What's up, Jib? Everybody needs a Jib. Yeah, now it's getting way orange. You can see this is like really, really morning-ish. I love it. I love twilight. Thanks, Lime. Appreciate it, man. So you can see the twilight has this really like game. It takes away colors. It actually takes away the amount of colors it can use. So just for a moment there, you saw it using a really unique color palette compared to the rest of the game. And that was only for, what, 30 seconds we saw that? I like it. Fleeting. Twilight is fleeting! Yes, Azimuth, there will be different stuff at night, yeah. There'll be secrets that are only accessible at night, mobs that only appear at night. I'm not exactly sure. I haven't planned it all out yet. So far it's just visual, but yes, eventually there'll be full-on gameplay differences at nighttime. So, looking for level 1, going to the northwest, playing the world seed called Fresh. Yeah, the guts are floating on the water. That's a visual bug for sure. It's so easy. I should write that down again. I know I already have this on my list somewhere. Guts should... Oh, this is so easy, actually. Guts can easily sizzle on the water. Or sink. Maybe they should sink. Sinking would be cool. I could see them like going down just a little bit and fading out when they hit water. Maybe it's salty water. So, wait, Northwest is kind of, I'm kind of blocked into the Northwest in this world. It's like we gotta go west first. Oh yeah, here we go. What's up? No music? There's supposed to be music here. What happened to the music for this guy? Music didn't play for Blob Boss. Or alien fish eat it. Ooh, cool idea. Right? Because that's some nutritious stuff. Blood with nanites? Oh, it's all of a sudden we start having some music. That was kind of weird, this boss got stuck up there. Alright. Oh, hey, good call, Boogie. Boogie has this amazing insight. He knows exactly where the levels are. Except for the north part. Okay, so I wonder if I actually have to cross this barrier here to get to that. Can't go this way? No? Can't go that way. That's a bug. Took a screenshot of that. Actually, let me delete my other screenshots. I'm not. Call that one bug. Yeah, you like the... Oh, I am headed east the whole time, dude. Oh, I'm so messed up in the head. What's up? Like, let's go east. This is cool. I like how this turned out. This is pretty much an accident. This must be level one. Well. All right. Let's do this. You like that switch, Sam's fan? North, south, north, south. Another thing that's really cool with the game lately is that there's more rewards. So, like, and this area right here might have some cool reward. If I kill these enemies. Okay, it doesn't, but can't have every area having a reward. But there's a lot more rewards in the game, so it becomes more rewarding to try and fight lots of enemies. Oh, another benefit, the new shadows. Look how they're really affecting this whole area. That's pretty sweet. Can you shut off shadows when on the platform? Yeah. I should do that, huh? What are these little touches? These guys are fast. Little bastards. There's nothing in here either. I got locked in. That's a bust. Good job, Boogie. Good job, man. I'm telling you, that's There's going to be a moment where you're so thankful for that. Which door should I open? This door? Whoop, I already opened it. Damn. Yes, I have temporary relief. Ooh, whoa, look at this. A corridor with an item. Bombs right here! Yeah! Where should I use these? Why is my bombs? I think I want those to be... Man, those guys give a lot of screen shake. Ooh, this is kind of a little dangerous corridor. Oh, wow, this room's really interesting. Bio detector, sweet. Where's the boss? Where's it at? Where do you think it is? Okay. Heading towards it. So should I try and get past these guys? Whoa! Oh! Juked him! Whoa! Another corridor room. This one has... Whoa! Oh, that blob! Did you see that? Damn, that blob totally like got knocked into me. That was cool. That was really fun. Alright, so that was straight to the right and then down. Hard room. Not as hard as that last one. Scanner drones. Doing this level right. We're playing for 18 minutes. Getting close to beating level 1. Pattern. All right, I like it. This little door? No, sun door. Oh, there's the boss room. Yeah, it's definitely loving these new shadows. They've really added a lot of depth to the art. Oh, bad place to swing the sword right there. Oh, I did not see that guy. Whoa! Ah! Screw this room. You like the falling tiles? Cool, man. Oh, I bum rushed that way too fast. Dang. This is great, man. I'm loving these surprises, and I'm loving the fact that, you know, this is my game, and it's kicking my ass. It's challenging. Maybe it's a bit too challenging, actually. I don't know. I'm probably just being dumb in this switch room. Which makes me wonder, I do have the 300 strategy to the new. Yeah, I know, the pulverizer changing direction. Okay, so I got a question for you guys, all right? This is a pretty important question. In the higher levels, like when you get to like level 6, level 7, and all those, maybe even level like 4, should there be maybe one room sort of in like the middle of the dungeon where you can save? Like, should you be able to save your progress in dungeons? That is my question for you guys. Because I'm debating that. I think it would be really handy and nice, actually. No? We got one vote for no. Alright. No saving, Lime Studios. Tell me some thoughts too. Tell me why you're voting the way you are. Depends on how big the dungeon is. Maybe killing a sub-boss. Oh, that's interesting. That's like Dark Souls. I'd love to hear more about more of you guys' thoughts on this, on why you would vote yes or no. Look at this guy. This guy did not do shit the whole time. He's just standing in the corner. Like he's chilling on the back of the bus. Oh, is he stuck? I think this guy's stuck. Yeah, he's totally stuck. I think he got like one pixel stuck right there. Yeah, see that blue? That blue means he's stuck. Oh, that was kind of weak. Alright, let me write this down. Because it would be weird to get a checkpoint. Alright. But the option to spawn in a previous room or at the beginning. Huh. You mean like a overall option? Like you have to set that in the settings of the game? Or like an option after you die? It would be continue from the beginning, continue from the middle, something like that. Synth King starting to pause. It's stuck. This is, what area is this? Area 401. Fresh 401. You like the Azenris idea? Azenris always has great ideas. Do doors remain unlocked after death? Yes. After you die, you do keep whatever doors you opened. If they do, then you don't need to save. True. Sounds like it would be awkward to implement it. It wouldn't be too bad. It would be I think I could put a whole dedicated room where you would either... save. So I like that. I like a mini boss idea. If it's a big old dungeon, maybe there's a mini boss where after you beat the mini boss, you can save there. Or maybe it's just... Oh, you're talking about an on death option. Minus one max courage to plan a checkpoint. Oh, awkward to implement for the player. Yeah. I hear ya. Okay. So far, I think Azurus's idea is one of the best ones so far. But it seems like you guys like that one the most, too. Oh, I didn't use my scanner drones? Oh no, scanner drones are getting stuck on. It's like a mulligan then, if you can only use it once. It's called like courageous memory. That's a very unique idea. I like that, why not? That could work. Oh, I'm so close to death. Oh, damn. Oh man, I gotta go fight the boss like this? Tell me there's some health right here. Nothing. Fight the boss with one heart. Memories of courage. Whoa, what the hell? No way. No, that can't be the boss. I forgot I added this mob, but this is way too hard for level 1. It should be called I Suck and Meet a Checkpoint. I know, right? This is like way too hard for level 1. But I'm gonna give it one more shot. I might have to pause the game, save the game, and go put this down to like less of these guys. This is ridiculous. Oh, I don't even need to lose a half heart like that. Best boss ever. It's 100% chance to get that item after being a certain mini boss that always spawns in Overworld. Huh. Okay, so what should I do? What should I do for this strat? Like, I used all my bombs. Damn it. If I had bombs, that would really help. Dude, I don't know what to do here. Oh my god. It's impossible, I'm telling you. It's like it works so fast. What the hell? One more try? This is almost pointless to try this. This is sick. Like, if I had tons of health and better armor and like a really awesome sword, this might be possible. You want to see it in permadeath? If this were permadeath, I'd already have lost. Okay, what's a strategy that could work here? A cactus would work, yes. A cactus would be essential right here. But there's nowhere in this dungeon so far that I could have gotten a cactus. Ugh! I was totally going for that health. Alright. I gotta make this easier. This is like way too unbalanced. So this is a quick... Yeah, your point exactly. So this is what mob is this. Raz. This is only supposed to be Z level 5 through 9. Oh, maybe it's this one. Boss 3. Nope, it would have put some... Oh, boss 4. No. Boss 4 should only be levels 5 through 9 or so. But let's put it back down to 1 and actually let's make it... If this were a boss and we were on level 1, how many rods should there be? Yeah, I know. Cactus would totally have helped. Bombs would have helped too. Like if I had gone out to the overworld and got some great items and come back in, maybe I could have done it. I'm thinking maybe 10 of those Razes could be doable, but that's still a lot. 5? Maybe more like 5. I think 5 might be a little easy. Let's try 7. We had votes for 5, but I'm going to try 7. Level times 20. One, that would be 20 on level 1. It's quite a surprise, though, to get hit with that. Level 1 had 40 of those guys that came out. It was sweet how they opened up, too. Like, they did that sweet, rad, accidental animation at the beginning. Oh, almost got through there without losing a half. Whole new level rage quit. Oh man! What? There's still a lot of them! What? Okay, we gotta check out the debug log on this. What did it put there? Alright, what do we got? Level 1 had boss 4 amount 0.5. Oh. Okay, it needs to be a little smarter about how it places bosses. Those could definitely go more than 7. Yes. So it's the amount factor became 0.5. So it needs to be smarter about its amount factor in flag boss. So world, when it places foes, 0.5 of 2,000. Oops. Add foes. There it is. Add foes. The amount factor. So if is boss, I already checked that somewhere. I don't know. Doesn't matter. If area.get flags and k flag boss, the amount factor is just going to be the level difficulty. So at this should be float k world. What's up, kick by kick? This is C++. Yep. Very close to C. -1. All right. Is that going to work, though? Let's see. Level difficulty. Oh, that's going to be 0. Amount factor equals level difficulty. Plus, plus 0.1. Clamp that between 0 and 1. So there. If it's a boss, it's gonna do its amount factor strictly based on its level difficulty. Not necessarily based on its difficulty 01, which is the difficulty of the level overall. Yeah, Boogie, once again, thanks for Bafu. And thank you, Bafu, for being so awesome. So that's gonna be amount factor. Let's run it once. Let's see what it did for an amount factor. Actually, this should apply to switches as well. Hold on. Wait. He's more real than any of us. Yeah, Bafu. Does Bafu know how awesome he is? Of course he does. Okay, so let's see what it did that time. It's 16 of them, because it had an amount 0.1. Okay, so amount should still be 0. And then, okay, so what did it do for the switch room? Mob 1, here it is. Amount 0.38. Okay, so this amount factor does not need anything. Amount factor just equals level difficulty. I'm gonna do the same thing for switch rooms. What did you call it, Jim? Pete and Wally, what's up? Spongebob inspired tracks, cool. Jim was taken, what? Who got the name Jim? Well, I mean, it's such a great name. Anybody would want that. So we had 30 to 40 blobs. That's still going to be a lot of blobs. It's only going to be slightly less blobs there. Yeah, flag switch. Good. So that should still give us an appropriate switch room. And then the boss and the switch rooms, the amount factor is solely based on the level of difficulty. And let's skip the menu. Yeah, bot foo. Hey, maybe there'll be a special, special mode of the game, or a special world seed where Jim is named bot foo. Okay, I'm just gonna verify how many of these guys there are. Boss, 4. Amount 0, difficulty 1. That puts 7. Exactly, that's what we wanted. Okay, that should still be hard. And then the mob 1, it still had 30 blobs, 5 blob 0s, 10 blob 2s, and 1 cent. So yeah, still looking good there. All right, we're ready to do this again. Let's play this. See how hard it is to fight 7 Razas at once. Victory! Bafu, yes, it would be a great seed. But there's no underscores, so it'd have to be something else with the maybe 2 U's or... I can't get through that room without losing half a heart. Hey, what happened to the door sound there? Did it play the door sound any of the times I've gone through here? Big door silent? Question mark. Lots of bugs. Lots of bugs found today. Wow! That is a really intense start. Whoa. Whoa. Jeez, these guys are super hard when they get all ganged up like this. They all have defenses and ranged attacks. Yes! Oh, yeah! Alright, I gotta say, this is definitely a difficult fight. But it's still possible. That was definitely possible. It should be easy for me, right? I'm the person that plays this every day. And that was a medium challenge for me. So, for new players, for newbies, this might actually need to be less than 7. Maybe we're like 5. I don't know. What do you guys think? Should it be less? Should it be more like 5 of them? Or should I keep it at 7? For level 1. Should make it 5 or 4 or 5, right? It's probably the prudent path here. 5.78. Five. Yep. We told you, right? Yeah. 3.75436. Okay, I'm just gonna change it right now while we're talking about it. We got mob 1, boss. What was it? Boss 4? Yeah. Raz 5 through 99. That would be crazy to fight that on level 9. There would be 99 of those. I don't even know if that's possible. You need the old school Doom difficulty screen? It's a pixel game. It deserves to be hard. I like that. But we got permadeath mode, so I think permadeath mode could be... Yes. Sadoff, you do have a good point. Because most people that... Yeah. I think you're right there. Because most people I think that would be attracted to this kind of game are going to be more of the hardcore kind of players. But, you know, it might as well ramp up, though, right? That was level 1. Oh, look at this. Stuck here. What do we got here? Why is there a problem? All right, that definitely needs to be noted. What are we at? Area 1210. Refresh. 12, 1, 0. Cannot leave. What's up, Caleb? Yeah. I like Lime Studios' point too, though. You just can't leave. Alright, so I gotta go into God mode to get out of this area. But I'll fix that bug. Whatever that bug was. Alright, where to next? We got time to play another level or two. I've only been playing this for half an hour. I'm excited. This is so great that the game is this fun to play where I want to keep playing. Yes, Wolfenstein, tell me all about it. How tough are you? Can I play, Daddy? Don't hurt me. Bring him on. I'm Death Incarnate. I remember this. Remember being a kid getting this on 5 1/4 floppy disks. How many? What was it, like 2 or 3 floppy disks, I think, for Wolfenstein? Permadeath should have bosses gang up on you. North! To the north it is! You want to play too? You can, man. Whoa, what? Are you serious? There's like another level right next to it. I don't know about this. Can you highlight the passive items? How so? What do you mean? You want me to like go over them? Yeah, Caleb, if you want to play this, there's an alpha version or update coming out this week. And if you want to play it, you can pre-order at songbringer.com/pre-order. I think there's a... So there's that item. There's that item. What's up, Rocket Bunny? Oh, you're asking if it was there? Yeah, yeah. I know, it looks like chess, right? Okay, and this area probably has the same bug. I don't know if I want to play this one. It's so close. Oh, let's try it. I kind of wanted to explore it. Whoa, what's going on? What? Straight to level 9. And holy crap, that was messed up. Alright, alright. I'm not gonna play that. Let's get back in there. Let's go back to level 1 where we were. I'll leave. And just not go to level 9. You want me to play level 9? Could be really hard. You want me to play it? Alright, I will. I'll play it. Let's see what happens. But I don't think I could have played it while it was messed up like that. But I need to check that. Why did level 9... Why did level 9 be all messed up? Elevator. He was totally hoverboarding. Alright, I don't want to accidentally throw down. Well, let's do this. Level 9. There could be 99 Raws at some point. Wait, why do I have... What is this? This is so messed up. I could go through a door I have no key for? Whoa. Man, this is so buggy. How did I introduce this many bugs in the last, like, 2 days? Level 9, door, allowed, first screen, so weird, bugs are real, it's all nanotech, fire ambience, yeah there is a fire ambience sound, it's hard to hear right now because there's music playing, but yeah, there is a fire ambience. Hold on a second, I wanna see, there shouldn't be any... There should be no key, yeah, there's no keys, and there should be no doors. Oh my god, look, there is doors. What? It opened up every door in the game, it looks like. Oh my god. Oh, when I beat the first level, it must have gone through and applied that same thing to every other level. Okay. Yeah, I got this. Let me stop the game real quick and fix that. So we only should have level one's doors open. I'm just gonna call this doors minus minus, and there'll be no doors. Okay. So I gotta write that down. That's another huge bug. It has to do with the Windows optimizations I made yesterday. Which turned out really well, by the way, everybody. Yeah, the Windows optimizations yesterday, so awesome. And I fixed the screen tearing as well. I could show that code if anybody's interested. Unlock all doors unlocked. All capital doors. You're so close to a K. You know what? That's gonna be a real Steam key soon, though. Okay, good. Yay, this door's locked. Here we are. We're playing level 9, and I literally have, like, level 2 items. This should be really hard. Oh, nice. This area has a reward. Show it? Show what? Oh, the points. Play level 9 here. We went straight from level 1 to level 9, and they were right next to each other, which is also a crazy bug of the game. The overworld generator should not put level 9 right next to level 1. I don't know how or why it did that. In fact, I have to note that. Probably one of the most important things to note right now. Why did it put level 9 right next to level 1? It's the question of today. I know, if only we had old watch minutes. Did it glitch? It might have looked like it was glitching, but it's because it was locking. So watch the doors when they open. When you go into a room that is locked, it will actually run the lock animation, which might look like a glitch, but it's not. Xbox Saga, is the game done? No. There's months and months left to do. It's still glitching. Oh, was it really a glitch then? Oh, a captain for the mobs. Yeah, I think there was a big guy. I don't have any keys yet, do I? What's up, Rooney? Yep, I'm playing the game, so I gotta hear it. So that's why I got headphones on today. I've just played level 1. It played pretty well, but there was a few little bugs and stuff. But here I'm on level 9. There's been tons of bugs so far. Gotta get better at my diagonal throws. Yeah, that was a good one. The screen's out? Is the stream okay? There should be a mob making all other mobs on the screen immune to damage until it's dead. Oh, Lazarus! Yes, like a leader. Totally. Yes, I love this idea. Mob leader. Mob leader, enemy, all other foes are immune till it's dead. That's a cool idea. I probably won't get to doing that before I release this alpha version, but definitely gonna do that afterwards. Yeah, watch it again. Watch it again when I get to another room that's locked. So I have one key now. Should I open that first door? Let's try the first door. Yeah, Xbox, right? The frogs? The frogs were definitely not even one of the first streams. That was a good 6 or 8 months into the development. Yeah, you can throw your hat through walls right now. Yeah, I guess you should probably get stop your hat when it goes through walls. Yeah. That's definitely something for later. For Jib too. Can't throw hat through walls. Oh, it looked fine that time? Huh. That bug you had where you couldn't leave the area and then the one where the elevator was over the ground looked like they might be related. Yeah. Oh, no, no. Why? Wait, maybe. Maybe, Caleb, yeah. Good thought there, man. That definitely could be it. Rooney, does the water count as a tile or an entity? It's both. Everything in the game starts as a tile and then it gets created as an entity. So literally every tile is an entity. What do you mean by that? Maybe I heard you wrong. This guy's playing hard to get right here. Damn! Jesus, die already. All right, we got some diamonds. I know, right? It's just the life of being a game developer, right? So many bugs. Every time you think you're doing well with your game, it's like you find 20 more bugs. But the good news is once these are done and they're no longer bugs, it will be that much better of a game. Oh, later, Lime. See, man. I mean, is there a tile under the water? No, no, there's no tile under the water. Man, I can't wait to add more types of enemies. That's really gonna help the game be more fun. See, this is one of those rooms that locks itself. Sweet, Frozen Clone, what's up, man? The stream's dead? Aww. Oh my god, there's two Songbringers running. Save. Cannot connect to the server.